this story, and I swear it's true. It's about Mad Jack and our Gungu.
Mad Jack was nobody's fool, sitting in back, keeping cool. The kids run out as Jack passed by, throwing mints with a twinkle in his eye. Keep on trucking, riding on through. Keep on heading, our Gungu. Kept his wheels and he kept his head. Kept his tiger, black, white, and red.
Black, white, and red? That's what I said. He kept his tiger.
Through the bush with his racing team, with his map and his tiger in the back. Our Gungu Jack was the first one back. Keep on trucking, ride on through. Keep on heading, our Gungu. Kept his wheels and he kept his head. Kept his tiger, black, white, and red.
Jack and our Gunga. 4 days, 3 nights, through bush and trees, through the desert sand, boulders and rocks. Man Jack and his crew beat the lot to our Gunga. The Flying Dutchman, the Flying Scot, and it's not Goblin 18, tried all they'd got. Making way for no one, they just had to win, to beat Mad Jack, his friends and crew, and be the first to Argungu. 13 vehicles died the very first day, and a poor old donkey flew away, and an eagle, and umpteen goats, and various quadrupeds met their match, meeting man-made metal monsters. It just didn't do. They couldn't beat Jack to Argungu. Bomber Bombardini went backwards up a tree. How he got there is a mystery to me. The Flying Dutchman, the Scot and 18 got stuck in the sand, and when they got free, went freeways through a village chasing me to Argungu. Through the hot hazy Hamertan and the cold windy nights, the remaining few madmen blazed their lights. And I lost the wheel, I would have won too, but where others had failed, Mad Jack, he came through. He kept his wheels, and he kept his head, and he kept his tiger black, white and red. And to my great surprise, Mad Jack and his crew took the prize at Argungu. Tiger.